Welcome to the first video in the acontis EtherCAT Main Device Software Implementation Guide video series. Over the course of these videos, we will cover what is involved in the development of an EtherCAT Main Device controller based around the acontis EtherCAT solutions EC Master, EC Engineer, and EC Simulator. Some familiarity with the acontis EtherCAT products is expected, so for more in-depth product tutorial videos, please check out our other videos. First, a note on some terminology as we will return to this same setup throughout this video series. We will use the terms main device and subdevice instead of master and slave, according to the EtherCAT Technology Group's inclusive language guidelines. We will refer to the hardware running the EtherCAT main device software, like EC Master, as the EtherCAT controller. Finally, for the overall system we are working on, which involves several different computing devices, we will refer to this as the EtherCAT Development Test Environment. In this first video, we will point you to various resources for getting more familiar with the EtherCAT technology. Set up the EtherCAT Development Test Environment, run the EtherCAT Main Device software, and verify the setup using EtherCAT Diagnostic software. To learn more about EtherCAT, the best resource is the EtherCAT Technology Group website. A lot of information is publicly available, but for more technical information, ETG membership is required. ETG membership is free, so we recommend contacting an ETG representative to become a member. Acontis also has an EtherCAT Technology Introduction webpage, and you can evaluate our software for free by simply requesting an evaluation via the forms on our website. Now let's get started. Here we have our EtherCAT development test environment. This includes the EtherCAT controller, which is an Advantech industrial PC running Linux connected to a monitor and keyboard, the subdevice, which is a Beckhoff EL9820 EtherCAT evaluation kit, a simple network switch for remotely accessing the EtherCAT network via TCP/IP, a Raspberry Pi for use in future videos, and an engineering laptop running Windows. Now we will connect the various cables. First, we will connect the EtherCAT controller to the in port of the subdevice for the EtherCAT communications. Then we will connect a secondary network port on the EtherCAT controller to the simple switch and connect the switch to the engineering laptop. Now that everything is connected, we can power on the controller, subdevice, and laptop. The next step is to run the EtherCAT main device software on the controller and verify the communication with the subdevice. Acontis EC Master software includes a simple example application that automatically sets the subdevices to the operational state. To run this example application, we will need to start it with the command line parameters specific to the setup we have. For an in-depth tutorial on EC Master running in Linux, please check out our EC Master tutorial video. Now that the EC Master example application is up and running, we can use EC Engineer on the engineering laptop to verify the communications by remotely accessing the controller over a TCP/IP connection through the switch. EC Engineer can remotely change the EtherCAT state, and this can be observed by the LED pattern on the subdevice. It is also possible to verify communications by toggling some switches on the subdevice and observing the process data variables changing in the EC Engineer user interface. For more capabilities of EC Engineer, check out our other videos in our EC Engineer tutorial playlist, as well as in our documentation, with links to both below in the description. Thanks for watching, and hopefully, this first video in our EtherCAT Main Device Implementation Guide series helps you get started with developing an EtherCAT Main Device controller. Stay tuned for our upcoming videos in this series where we will cover more topics related to the main device software development and testing. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below or you can contact us on our website.